Visible Body has all the content students need to learn about embryonic and fetal development from fertilization to birth in dazzling 3D. This is part two of our series on embryology, where we'll show you how you can use these resources to understand fetal development, fetal circulation, changes to the mother's body during pregnancy, and the birth process. If you haven't seen part one, click the link in the description to watch it now. First, we'll explore the 30 to 32 week pregnant mother 3D model. The mother here is well into the third trimester, which lasts from 28 to 42 weeks. By now, most of the fetus's body systems are starting to resemble their final developmental stage. We can select the amnion and amniotic fluid and see how they surround and protect the fetus. We can highlight the other layers, such as the chorion, as well. The placenta is a lot more developed in this model than the 8 to 10 week fetus model. We can see that it has lots of blood vessels and connects to the umbilical cord to allow for the exchange of nutrients, waste, and gases between the mother's bloodstream and the baby's. Let's take a look at the fetal circulation pathway 3D lesson to learn more. We'll see the placenta in greater detail, as well as the umbilical cord and its blood vessels. Oxygenated blood flows through the umbilical vein from the placenta through the ductus venosus, which bypasses the fetus's liver. Blood flows from the ductus venosus to the inferior vena cava, then onto the heart's right atrium. In the right atrium, this oxygenated blood mixes with deoxygenated blood that enters through the superior vena cava. Most of the mixed blood passes through the foramen ovale into the left atrium. Then it passes into the left ventricle and out through the aorta to the fetus's body tissues. The fetus's lungs aren't taking in any oxygen yet, so the foramen ovale is a shortcut that lets already oxygenated blood skip the pulmonary loop. It closes shortly after birth, when the newborn's lungs begin to function. Remember, in the adult heart, deoxygenated blood enters the right atrium, passes into the right ventricle, and then goes out through the pulmonary trunk and pulmonary arteries to receive oxygen from the lungs. Then, oxygenated blood returns to the left atrium via the pulmonary veins, passes into the left ventricle, and is pumped out to the body's arteries through the aorta. And now, back to the fetus. After oxygenated blood travels through the fetus's arteries to reach its body tissues, the umbilical arteries return deoxygenated blood to the placenta. It's worth mentioning that not all of the blood from the right atrium passes through the foramen ovale. Some of it enters the right ventricle, where it is pumped through the pulmonary trunk and bypasses the lungs via the ductus arteriosus. Later, this joins the blood returning to the placenta through the umbilical arteries. If we return to the 30 to 32 week mother and fetus model, you'll also notice that the fetus now looks a lot more like a baby, with distinct facial features and limbs. In addition, the fetus is getting in a head-down position in preparation for birth. The 30 to 32 week model doesn't just show the fetus and uterus, it shows the changes that the mother's whole body undergoes during pregnancy. We can use the Pregnancy Changes 1 and Pregnancy Changes 2 3D lessons to see what those are. We'll start with the changes that are visible from the outside, like stretch marks and weight gain, as the mother's body accommodates the growing fetus. The mother's posture, that is, the position of her spine, also changes as her center of gravity shifts. Changes in hormone levels can cause pigmentation changes in the skin, including dark spots on the face and chest, and darkened, enlarged areolas. Some mothers also develop a dark line, or linea nigra, from the umbilicus to the pubic area during the second and third trimesters. These changes are usually temporary, going back to normal after pregnancy. And then, there is swelling of the legs and varicose veins, caused by factors including increased fluid retention, hormonal changes, and obstructed blood flow caused by the growing uterus. Next, we'll look at the internal changes to the mother's body. Her breasts enlarge and prepare to produce milk, and her lungs are compressed by the growing uterus. Vasodilation, or widening of the blood vessels, leads to increased cardiac output, heart rate, and blood flow, but can also cause lightheadedness, dizziness, and fatigue. The growing uterus shifts organs in the abdomen and pushes on the bladder. The round ligaments have to stretch a lot to support the uterus, which can lead to pain. Another source of pain or discomfort is the stretching of the pubic symphysis. Additionally, the rectus abdominis muscles can separate, a condition called diastasis recti, which can be addressed with physical therapy if it persists after the baby is born. Speaking of birth, let's take a look at the birth illustration for a quick overview. The stages in the illustration show how the smooth muscle of the uterus contracts, the cervix softens and dilates, and the fetus is pushed out, followed by the placenta. The positive feedback loops animation gives a more detailed explanation of how the stretch receptors in the uterine wall signal the hypothalamus in the brain to signal the posterior pituitary gland to release oxytocin, which triggers more frequent and intense contractions until the fetus leaves the mother's body. As you can see, it's hard work growing a tiny human, and it's a pretty amazing process to be able to see in 3D. You can find even more reproductive system and endocrine system content in VB Suite. Visit us at visiblebody.com/VBSuite to learn more.